Good evening, sir. Thank you so much for joining us here on this platform. It's such a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you, ma'am. Same here.
So, being the chairman of Barkliwal Foundation College of Arts, Commerce and Science, what is your philosophy of leadership? And how would you describe your leadership style?
If you ask about my leadership style, it's a very flexible. I work out the things as in when it comes to me, with a very confidently, with the, like a theory that we properly design as our vision. On vision we work out, and exactly with the vision, our alignment is that we how to create the path and to walk on that. So it is like a complete system which we have to follow for our leadership philosophy.
So what are the factors that keep you connected with the education sector?
In fact, it's a need of the hours. I have seen that education is the backbone of any economy. And to make a development in any nation, education is the major factor. And I have come across with many incidents where I find that if I work in this field nicely, then I can do something, I can make a good contribution to the nation by doing the wonderful education system into the country.
So what do you think your roles and responsibilities to the institute and the students are?
If you look at my role to the institute, it is everything. Every part of the institute I have to take care of. And the momentum of growth should be accepted to the society as well as to whole every stakeholder of this, my institute. I feel that the wholesome growth of any student is our basic priority, which we will be looking into.
So what are some of the biggest challenges you see both for higher education in general and for Barkliwal Foundation College specifically?
People are there who can have a degree, but what about degree? After degree, what exactly the life is totally different. So exit point is very important when we make a student very perfect who can face the challenges of the world. That is the point where we have to work on. And that's like Barkliwal Foundation is dedicated to look into this one.
So what are some plans that you currently or will be designing for the institute students?
Plans are basically good course, very good faculty, very good kind of the setup, market studies. What is the need of the market? We have to align with that. And if you ask me that to bridge the gap, there is a lot of expectation from the institute, from the market point of view, industry point of view. And we have to align those kind of things in our students so they can face the world very confidently.
So how does the curriculum of Barkliwal Foundation College ensure the best practice of the industry?
Curriculum is generally designed by the universities. So we don't want to just make a greater changes in that one. But apart from this set curriculum, we are planning such kind of the additional things, extracurricular support to our students where they can face, they can maintain their decorum, they can maintain themselves into this challenging world, and they can do something better than what people, other institutes people are doing right now at present.
So as private universities continue to mushroom across the country, how does your institute stand apart from the others?
Why we should compare with the private universities? I don't want to compare. You know why? Because the universities basically are there are the one of the finest, there are very very finest universities available, though are private, but doing very well. But there are some kind of government universities also, they are doing wonderful job. So now we are not there to compete with anyone. We want to be unique one. What I understand that the best courses which can be designed as per the need of the market can bring a lot of goodwill, a lot of reputation of our institute. Though we are offering very recognized degree, UGC, approved, recognized institute. We are university we are giving, and we will be having the courses which is other good universities are offering. Other good universities. I mean to say there are a lot of good private universities. They are doing very well. So we would like to have some of the courses of those universities, and we want to blend it with our government degree courses. So people who are having our who are with us should feel proud once they have a degree from our college.
So how do you look at the placement opportunities offered by your institute, and how do you plan to push the envelope further?
This is a very favorite question of to be answered by me. I'm basically a chartered accountant, and I'm advisor to many of the my group. They are basically into different segments, maybe the real estate, maybe into hospital, maybe into shipping industries, maybe into some manufacturing, even banking also. So we have a well connections with these kind of industries. So what we are seeing that we, you know, backward integrations, which is we are going to offer to our students, is that once they come and do the degree with us, do the degree course with us, then there is a, like a huge kind of the chances, huge kind of the opportunity they'll get to connect with the industry directly with our contacts. And we know what is their need. We can design the course as per the need of the industry, and we can add on to our this existing degree courses. What will happen then? Once they have a degree which is offered by the UGC approved university, plus the all kind of support system which we are providing them to face the challenges of the world, maybe industry wise also, that will be good for them. That is what I understand. Placement will not be a problem for us, and we can do a wonderful job in the placements.
So what do you think should be the institute's top priority of the next 10 years?
Shalbi, children are our top priority, and we want that they should have a holistic development and complete development. For that, whatever we have to do, we will be taking care of that. And we want to take care of the students, not from the date of the admission till forever. They will be a part of our Barkleywell family, where we would like to make them proud that whatever things they have learned from this institute will help them out in their practical life.
So any suggestions you would like to give to the current youth and the aspiring students?
Shalvi, very interesting question. And though I definitely would like to give answer on that about the youth part, they are very energetic people. So I wish if this question is answered by my son, Naman Barkleywell. He's also there with me. And he's 23-year-old chartered accountant and helping hand to me running my education. So I wish that let Naman should give the answer for this one.
It's my pleasure to be the part of this interview. And though I'm not experienced enough, but all I could say to the youth, and after my this journey of becoming a chartered accountant also, is that there are two aspects of life, and what I have seen in today's youth is that they are more on a creative side, and they focus more on smart work. What I have seen my dad and my ancestors do is they were more of an hardworking personalities, and they used to never get afraid of working hard. But nowadays, what I see and when I interact with the youth, what I feel is that they need proper direction, and if they have beautiful and wonderful ideas. So if they get converted into some commercial ideas, so that, you know, they become more sustainable ideas. So that is what I would want to advise them, that never, never reduce your passion, never reduce your, you know, that drive of the creativity, but always, you know, balance your life in such a way that one side you focus on your degree, one side you focus on creating your personality, that is like a recognition for the society, and on the other side you keep on pursuing your passion also. And what I feel, if one has a passion, then there's no time limit that main subah hi kaam kar paunga ya raat ko, whatever time it is, they can, or he or she can work it. So that is what my advice to the youth is, to balance their life properly, and to, you know, idolize a person with whom they can get proper direction. In the right direction, they can just channelize their energy, and you know, that is what an wholesome advice which I can give to the youth nowadays.
That was a very insightful message, Naman. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Sanjesh, for being with us on this interview. Yeah. Here.
So great. Shall we? That is a, like a we are trying very hard to make the things very this product very powerful, and we wish that the people who get affiliated associated with us should feel proud that they have done the course with us, because it is properly blended with this theory with the practical approach. So thanks a lot for your all this taking pain to take interview of mine and my Saman Naman, and all the best.
Thank you so much, sir.